How far we have come. Good evening and thank you for inviting me to tell the African side of this story. In the 1960s, France tested more than 16 nuclear bombs in Algeria in a grotesque act of what Ghana's first post-independence president, Kwame Nkrumah, termed nuclear imperialism. The tests had devastating consequences for local communities at these sites and neighboring countries that experienced nuclear fallout. Several African states had their own plans for nuclear weapons, Egypt, Nigeria, Libya, but only one went through with it, apartheid South Africa, that wanted to use the bomb to blackmail Western countries into helping them sustain a racist regime. So how far have we come? In 1990, South Africa dismantled its nuclear weapons as one of the first acts to end apartheid, and in 2003, Libya ended its clandestine program. In 1996, the Pelindaba Treaty was adopted and entered into force 10 years later, making Africa, and in conjunction with other treaties, the whole southern hemisphere a nuclear weapon-free zone. The treaty expressed the official African approach of abolition. But for Africans, abolition of nuclear weapons is not just a continental affair under the norm of non-proliferation, as nuclear-armed states would label it. It has always been a global affair. In 1962, for example, Kwame Nkrumah organized an assembly in Ghana under the theme, A World Without the Bomb. And this theme reverberates through African efforts in the NPT and also in their support of the Ban Treaty. The TPNW ends nuclear imperialism in two ways. It entitles those communities affected by nuclear testing to reparation, and it installs nuclear equality. Nuclear weapons are illegal for all, not just for some. The TPNW also codifies the norm against nuclear weapons in international law that will become stronger over time. The delegitimizing effect of the treaty should not be underestimated. After the first nuclear test in the Sahara, President de Gaulle honored the general responsible, sending him a note saying, "Hooray for France! This morning she is stronger and prouder. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you and those who have achieved this magnificent success." I foresee that in the future, just as the Kellogg-Briand Pact that outlawed wars of aggression was used in the Nuremberg and Tokyo trials, the Ban Treaty will be holding those who make decisions and work for nuclear weapons to account. This is the message we need to send out to people who still favor nuclear weapons and work towards them. In the future, you will be shamed. You will stand trial. You will have to pay. You will not get a Medal of Honor. You will not be a hero. Thank you.